Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Yes, youngsters, those that are watching the Ummah Squad, this video is for you. As we understand, 1441, that's our year that is setting in, the Islamic New Year. Now, as we understand, the month of Muharram heralds in the beginning of the Islamic New Year. New Years are generally considered as a time for resolutions. While the world generally focuses on material resolutions, we need to re-look at the resolutions we adopt, so that the positive change can occur in our lives, communities, and the Ummah at large. Now, understanding, remember, we are the Ummah Squad. So, of course, let's see how we can make a positive change with regards to a dini perspective. Now, in order to achieve this with me in studio, I have Radio Islam International presenter, Hafidh Hanzala Hafeji, inshallah, who's going to be changing or having a shift of focus. Instead of aiming at the material growth, let us aim for spiritual growth. Now, instead of worrying about our physical appearance, why not improving our inner selves? And with regards to that, we have, of course, as I've mentioned, Hafidh Hanzala Hafeji. And later on during the show, we're going to be having Mulana Muhammad Bham, who is going to be giving us a more detailed insight about what to actually do around the 10th of Muharram. Sit back, relax, and enjoy the show. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Hafidh Hanzala Hafeji, jazakallah for joining us on the Ummah Squad. Now, as we understand that we're putting focus Muharram 1441, the new year, Islamic new year 1441 after Hijrah setting in, we as the Ummah Squad understand that, remember, we as the Ummah of Nabi sallallahu alaihi wasallam want to attain that spiritual growth. Now, at the same time, we understand many people have material growth, understanding the Gregorian calendar. What do we mean if you put us through the perspective of what material growth is and at the same time what type of spiritual growth we need to attain?
Wa alaikum salam wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Naumaan, jazakallah for having me on the Ummah Squad. Well, when we're focusing on material growth, people tend to look at growing in aspects like better lifestyles, better cars, better houses. On the other hand, we have spiritual growth, which is very important for us as well.
Yes, perfect. As you've touched on how people would like to attain that material growth and they want to get better jobs, better houses, a lot of money, those are the perspectives that they require. But as you've mentioned, that we are going to be touching on spiritual growth as our New Year resolution, as the Ummah Squad, as the Ummah of Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, the different types of spiritual growth that we can attain, I understand, you know, be touching on character as well, touching on how you go about in your day-to-day lives, your different business dealings, how all of that makes you attain that spiritual growth and you attaining the pleasure of Allah Subhanahu Wa Ta'ala. So yes, Hafidh Hanzala, touching on some of them, if you want to go in more detail for us on how we can attain it.
Some ways in which we can spiritually grow, focusing on aspects such as honesty, integrity, trustworthiness, and love for humanity, as all of these are precious resources. Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam profoundly observed, "Verily, Allah does not look at your physical features, nor at your wealth, rather, He looks at your hearts and your deeds."
Yes, some pertinent points raised there. Touching on also having our focus on Salah and turning to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, having that prayer at the center of our life. How do we go about that? How do we make that a resolution?
Naumaan, speaking about this important aspect of focusing on Salah, remember that Salah is at the center of our lives. At times we forget to focus on Salah, we tend to forget to read our Salah, but the most important thing is that no matter where we are, what challenges we are having, what we are doing, keep Salah at the center of our lives. Perform your Salah first before you carry out any other action.
Indeed, and also touching also at the same time on, you know, you doing all the prayers, you do all the ibadah, all the worship of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We as youngsters, you know, sometimes we get caught up in the mess with what we would say, engaging yourself in gossip, engaging yourself in those kind of sinful acts. Remember, these points affect you mentally, affect you physically, affects you spiritually. It's something that plays on your mind all the time. How do we protect our amals? You've done the good actions, but at the same time, you don't have something where you're protecting the worship that you've done, the actions that you've carried on, or the actions where you initially attain the pleasure of Allah, but at the same time, how do we protect it?
You know, looking at the aspect of gossiping itself is one of the dangerous aspects which exists within our societies. In order to protect ourselves, protect others as well. Remember, try not to hurt somebody else's feelings. Put the other person's feelings before your feelings and try to understand how would they actually feel if they knew this was happening. Try to avoid this at all times, and remember, if somebody had to be discussing or gossiping about you, you wouldn't like it. Remember that the other person also doesn't like it.
Okay, since there's some very pertinent points raised there, and I think we can just touch on one final point before we wrap up this segment. I just want to speak about the focus on Allah. That point is of utmost importance, how we can understand that that needs to be our main focus, our main objective in today's time and forever, till we leave this world. How is we as youngsters could understand that, you know what, if you have the focus on Allah, automatically, if you are conscious of the omnipresence of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, at that time, doesn't that allow us to put all our other amals in place, and at the same time we understand that, you know what, we're going to stay away from sin, everything just falls in place. How do we go about it? Can you just touch on a bit of that quickly?
Remembering the concept of Tawheed, Naumaan, we need to understand that this is the central aspect of our lives, and also when we put Allah at our focus, it allows everything else to fall into place, and we tend to grow in our religion, and we tend to become a better Muslims because we are continuously reminding ourselves of who is there in our presence at all times. Automatically, this helps us achieve a lot more in our life, and also we tend to become more spiritually grown because we know that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is always watching us.
Hafidh Hanzala, jazakallah so much for your time on the Ummah Squad. Just some notes to end up with?
One last point. Honesty, integrity, and trustworthiness, and love for humanity are also very important and precious resources. Though they may not have monetary values, they are indeed more valuable than gold and silver. Remember, 1441, the spiritual trophy.
Indeed, jazakallah so much for your time. We really appreciate it.
Jazakallah for having me.
Joined now by Maulana Muhammad Bham, a Radio Islam International presenter, and he's going to be giving us more insight about the 10th of Muharram, the different actions that we can carry out, and at the same time, the rewards that we will get, inshallah, by carrying out all those auspicious acts on these special days in Muharram. Maulana, jazakallah for your time. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
Wa alaikum assalam wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Jibra bin Oman. There are many rewards for the fasting on the day of Ashura. Now, let's just go back to the day of Ashura itself. When Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam came to Medina and he found that the Jews that were in Medina, they were fasting on the 10th of Muharram. So he asked them, for what reason are you fasting? And they mentioned that the Prophet Musa alayhi wa sallam was saved on this day from Fir'aun. So Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says that we have a better right to Musa alayhi wa sallam compared to you. So we will also fast, the next year we will also fast on the 10th of Muharram. However, just to show a difference between the Muslims and the Jews, we will also fast the 9th and the 10th, or the 10th and the 11th. So as Muslims, we should fast on the 9th and the 10th, or the 10th and the 11th. Also, Hadith of Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam goes, the best of fast after Ramadan is the fast of Ashura. The best of fast after the month of Ramadan is the fast of Ashura. So a person who fasts on Ashura, that is the 9th and 10th, or the 10th and 11th, and that person will have atonement for his sins from the previous year.
Yes, indeed, some great rewards in store for us. And also touching on the auspicious month, you know, understanding that we don't want to create that type of bid'ah, those things that are not part of Sharia. Exchanging gifts have become a thing on the day. Is it permissible, just to clarify it, is it permissible in Islam to exchange gifts on this day specifically, any rewards to it, or it's something that we need to just re-understand the concept of it?
Exchanging gifts is a good deed that a person should do at any other day, not on a specific day. Mm-hmm. However, people have brought this into Islam that on this specific day, if you exchange gifts, you get extra reward. It doesn't hold any value in Islam. A person can exchange gifts at any time of the year. And some people go to this extent that when they don't even have anything, they take out loans so that they can buy gifts for family members. This shouldn't be done. Gifts should be given out at any other time of the year.
And lastly, understanding that the rewards that if a person spends in the month of Muharram or on the days of Ashura for his family members, then of course we have that in our minds that, you know, inshallah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will reward us, give us barakah and blessings throughout the year in all our aspects. For example, one small example, maybe a small person spending 100 rands on his supper, he should increase it.
It's good to spend a little bit extra on your family to show that it is the day of Ashura, and there is a saying of Nabi Sassam that goes that a person who spends a little bit extra on the day of Ashura, then he will get barakah for the whole year. So normally a person will make a special type of dish on this day, although not going too extravagant when we're doing this. Also, not as we mentioned, that don't put yourself into debt when you're doing this. because now you're putting yourself into another problem. Trying to practice in the Sunnah of Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, rather something which is mustahab, the person is putting himself.
JazakAllah Muhammad Bham for your time on the Ummah Squad. We really appreciate it, and we hope inshallah that our viewers as well as our listeners can benefit from this small segment. Yes, as we've heard some very pertinent points by Hafidh Hanzala Hafeji as well as Muhammad Bham, we hope inshallah that you, the viewers as well as the listeners, can inshallah try and put some of these points into our life, and at the same time make those our New Year resolutions. For myself, Naumaan Pancbhaya, your host on the Ummah Squad show, we really appreciate your time. Make sure that you do leave your comments in the section below. And yes, hit a like and look forward to more awesome videos on the Ummah Squad. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.